I've made this video specifically for those of us that struggle with gaining weight and you just want to know what are the best exercises to make sure you include in your routine and you want to make sure you gain mastery of in order to gain weight in all the right places. Let's talk about this. I said this in previous videos, but I'm going to say it again. I just need you to know upfront, regardless of the topic of this video, that you are beautiful. But anyways, we're talking about exercises to gain weight quickly. The first thing is that obviously you need to take care of your diet and nutrition and consume more calories than you burn. That is the basic principle of weight gain. Now, even though I say it's obvious that you need to consume more calories than you burn, it's not always easy. Sometimes you don't have control over your meals. Sometimes you don't have an appetite. You just don't feel like eating. So it's hard to eat more. And the other thing to this too is when you eat more calories, you're not really trying to go for belly fat with those extra calories. You're trying to go for that toned abs, the popping booty, the nice lean arms. So this is where exercise comes in and it can really help you out in gaining that weight in all the right places. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about the 5 best exercises that you need to really know how to do really well in order to gain weight quickly. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't done so already. Let's talk about these exercises for gaining weight. Let's move on to the first exercise. The first exercise we're going to talk about today is push-ups. I know you didn't see that one coming, but push-ups are actually one of the most effective, efficient, and necessary exercises to master in the quest to gain weight. It doesn't matter if you're working out at home or at a gym or outside. If you're looking to gain weight, then push-ups are definitely something that should be part of your routine. There are so many variations of push-ups, but my personal favorites are the wide push-up and the half push-up. If you really hate push-ups or you're totally new to exercise, you've never done push-ups before, you've never been able to master them, definitely start with the wide push-up on your knees. Here's how to do a wide stance half push-up. I recommend doing this in front of a mirror, and you can even do it with me as you're watching this video to see if you understand this and how to do it correctly. The first thing you do is you start in a kneeling position. Next, you want your hands to be outside of shoulder width apart. You can technically go as far wide as you want. As long as it's outside of shoulder width apart, you're gonna be good to go. Are you doing it with me? Try it with me. Make sure your palms are flat on the ground and facing forward. You can use the edge of your mat as a guide so that your palms are straight and make sure your palms are flat on the floor. Now you want to go down and bring your chest down to elbow level. If you want to make this harder and you have the mobility to do so, you can bring your chest all the way down to the ground. Once you can do 12 of these, you can then graduate into doing the full push-up in that same wide stance. So you're still going to do exactly the same thing. The only difference is that now your legs are extended out as if you are doing a full plank. And then same as with the half push-up, you'd bring your chest down to elbow level. And if you want to make it more difficult, you can take your chest all the way to the mat and then go back into your starting position. One of the reasons I love the wide push-up is because it is beginner friendly and it also targets your chest, which is one of the biggest muscle groups in the body, but tends to be ignored in a lot of workouts for women. For really good, effective muscle development, you kind of want to be able to do 10 to 15 of these within 30 seconds. If you're doing my workout videos, you would typically have that 30 second counter going. Do as many as you can. Now, if you're totally new to push-ups, you may not be able to do 10 to 15 within 30 seconds. And if that's you, that's totally okay as well. It's okay to just try it out, see how many you can do. And then from there, you just gradually and slowly increase and just do as many reps as possible within 30 seconds. You will find that eventually you can do 25 push-ups in 30 seconds because you're just like, bam, 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 bam. Because, you know, that's how we do push-ups. Yeah. Doing push-ups regularly will have a drastic impact on your overall strength within just a few weeks, and you will start to see a visible effect in the toning of your upper body. Other than helping you gain weight, aka lean muscle, push-ups will also help you tone your stomach muscles if you're doing them correctly, because you really need to engage that core to make sure that your body is as straight as possible and you're not hiking your butt to the ceiling. So you're not going to be bulky from doing push-ups. That's almost impossible, especially for women. Exercise number 2, a squat. Squats are very effective for toning up the thighs, getting that booty to act right. And just like push-ups, there are so many variations of squats. A personal favorite of mine is the wide stance squat, especially if you have a weight to hold on to while you do the squat. I have a 60-pound kettlebell that I love, and I tend to alternate between doing my squats with my 60-pound kettlebell and doing them with just body weight. I like them both. I do them both. It is awesome. To do your wide stance squats correctly, if you have a kettlebell or really any weight at all, small. Make sure that your legs are wider than shoulder width apart. Your feet should be flat on the floor. Sit back and drop down low. If you're using a kettlebell or a weight, it tends to be a really good guide because when you feel that weight touch the floor, you know you've reached a pretty good depth and you can stand back up. You want to make sure that your core is sucked in, your head is up, you are facing forward, you're not looking down at the thing you're carrying, because if you look down at the thing you're carrying, you're curving your spine and you're putting yourself at risk for injury. When you stand, you have to mentally think about that muscle in your glutes and squeeze them to stand up. When you first start doing this, you may not feel the muscle doing anything and you may think you're just wasting your time. Push through. That is normal. Everybody goes through that. The more you do it, the better you get at it. The more your body will remember the movement and then you will start to feel it and then it will start to pay off. Also remember that with your squats, it's not about how many squats you can do really, really fast. It's all about the quality of your reps. Just like the push-ups, see what your body can do and just do that and then increase from there. A really good tip that I like to give, and this is something that helps me out a lot in the beginning of my journey, was whenever I would do exercises, I would write down how many reps I could do of something in a given amount of time, and then the next workout, I would try to do more. So if I could only do 3 push-ups, then I would try to do 4 the next time around, or I would push myself to do 5, and that's how I was able to build up my strength to be able to do tons of push-ups and tons of squats and tons of really any exercise that normally I would usually find quite difficult to do. Next exercise we're going to talk about is the overhead press. The overhead press is such an awesome exercise to gain muscle in the back. Similar to the push-up, it's so important to gain muscle in the back because this is another huge muscle group in the body, and if you can build lean muscle there, your body is going to be torching fat while you're having snacks and taking a nap, and I think that's a good deal. And if you're looking for an efficient way to gain that weight fast, then you can't avoid these big muscle groups. They must be targeted. So doing the overhead press will definitely help you build lean muscle mass. It will help you gain that weight that you want to gain. And I will say that this is one exercise that can be done with body weight only, but if you have some dumbbells, it's a good idea to include them in this particular exercise just to get a little bit more resistance going for your back muscles to work with. Start with a lighter weight, something that you know you can handle, and then slowly increase your weight up from there. So to get your overhead press correct, it's very important to make sure that your legs are wide so your body has a stable base. You want a soft bend in your knee. You're gonna raise your arms up with your elbows bent if you choose to use weight. Now just slowly raise your hands up, nice and slow. Once your arms are fully extended, bring them back down and stop once your upper arm is parallel to the floor. Something that's gonna happen when you try to do this is that your arms are going to try to come forward. They may try to wobble. This is where control is really important. Don't worry about going fast. Focus on just that slow, controlled burn. You're gonna feel this burn in your shoulders. You're also gonna feel this in the back of your arm, the tricep area. But you also really want to mentally think about your back muscles. For a lot of us, we don't use our back muscles as often as we use other muscles in our body, like our arms, our core, our legs. And so it may take a while to really feel this working, but just like the push-up and just like the wide stance squats, it's so important to just push through that beginning stages of feeling like it's not doing anything and always mentally think about the muscle. This is why I like to include these visuals so you can try to picture what your back should be looking like as you're doing the overhead press. The best time to engage your back muscles is when you're coming down. When you're bringing those arms down, squeeze the muscles in your back and you will feel it. Next exercise, lunges. Lunges are awesome for targeting the lower body and challenge the deep core muscles that help your body balance. Now, I know a lot of people struggle with knee pain and I plan to do a video about that to kind of help you figure out what exercises to do and how to manage that knee pain. So don't worry about that. Of course, make sure you talk to your doctor if you have knee pain, but I am planning to do a video to help you out with that. But the thing is, if you are able to do lunges, we cannot deny the power of lunges. This is one exercise that you will get results just from doing it with body weight. Once you are an expert level and you're looking for a greater challenge, you can definitely carry dumbbells, but just body weight alone is already fire when it comes to lunges. So let's talk about just regular body weight lunges. You want to stand with your feet aligned with your hips, so your feet are about hip width apart. Take a deep breath and just suck your core in. Now, you're not holding your breath. You're just engaging your core muscles. What that means is that you are making your core muscles, the muscles in your abs, very hard. If I poke your stomach, I should feel the muscle in there working. That's what I mean by engaging your core. Once you achieve that, step your foot out, any foot you prefer, and allow your back to come down toward the floor without actually touching the floor. The key is to make sure that the knee of the foot that stepped out doesn't go past your toes. And also the knee in the back doesn't touch the floor.
floor.
If you are a beginner, I recommend just doing one leg over and over and over till you get your reps. So for example, if you're trying to do 12 reps of lunges, I would recommend starting with whichever leg you prefer and just doing 12 reps of that leg, then switch legs and do the other legs. This is a great way to really master your lunges instead of doing the traditional alternating lunges. For a lot of people, especially if you're a beginner, doing the alternating lunges the traditional way can be very inefficient because of all the time spent thinking on, am I doing it right? Am I not doing it right? And also there tends to be a tendency to wobble a little bit and kind of almost fall over. And that usually makes people's knee pain worse. And sometimes that actually creates knee pain for people. So alternating lunges are good if they are done correctly, but a very good hack is what I just described, which is doing one leg at a time to get the same results without falling over, without hurting your knees, and without being stressed that you're not doing it correctly. Let's talk about dips. The awesome thing about dips is that you do not need any equipment for this. All you need is a floor or a box or a bed or a chair and you are good to go. You're gonna be using your body weight for the resistance here and this is highly effective for gaining weight. Dips are an exercise that are really focused on those arm muscles to get them strong and toned. Here's how I personally love doing my tricep dips. You want to find any elevated surface that's stable. Grip the edge of that stable surface with your palms. That's it. Your palms should be facing down, your fingertips should be facing down. Extend your legs out, take a deep breath, and lower your booty to the ground. Something that's gonna happen when you're doing dips is that your elbows are going to want to flare out. They're gonna wanna be like chicken wings. Try to avoid that. Try to keep your elbows facing back the whole time. This means you're keeping your arms really close to your body. And it also means that when you're placing your arms, you want your arms to be around waist width apart. This will take some getting used to, and some of you may even struggle to even get into this position. This is a very, very intense exercise for your arms, especially if you're not used to working your arms in this way. Doing these exercises plus being in a calorie surplus will definitely help you gain weight and gain weight quickly. Of course, make sure that your calorie surplus makes sense for your height, your weight, and your goals. There are so many calculators online that you can use to figure out your calories, so definitely take advantage of all those free resources. If you're enjoying this video so far, make sure you visit kobokofitness.com. Check out my booty program. It's an 8-week program you can do at home with minimal equipment, and it is awesome. Highly recommend it. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't done so already, and I'll see you in my next video.